Good morning and welcome to you all. Before we start, could I please just ask you to ensure that your mobile phones are switched to silent or on off? Thanks. My name is Rhonda Edwards, and it's my privilege to be conducting this service for Peter John Truman, fondly known as Bondi. On behalf of the family, I'd like to thank you all for being here today as we celebrate Peter's life and remember the special connection each of you have with him. I would also like to welcome and acknowledge those that are unable to be here today and are watching our service through the live stream function. A special warm welcome to Peter's brother Alan, who unfortunately cannot be with us today. So welcome to you all. In the darkest hour, when shadows fall, when the weight of loss embraces you all, you gather here with heavy hearts, bound by the pain that death imparts. For death may claim this loved one's breath, but his spirit lives on, defying death. In cherished moments, laughter and embrace, Peter's essence lingers, leaving an everlasting trace. Today, we honour a life and gather together to comfort and support each other as we farewell this wonderful man. Bondi's life has touched you all in unique ways, leaving an unforgettable imprint on your hearts. In times of grief, when our hearts ache with loss and our souls feel heavy with sorrow, we are reminded of the profound truth. Love is our most valuable currency. It is the thread that weaves through the fabric of our lives, connecting us to one another in the deepest and most meaningful of ways. Overcoming grief is deeply personal, and it's an individual journey. You will all grieve differently for different lengths of time. So be kind to yourself, as the healing process cannot be forced or hurried, and it certainly cannot be compared to others. Our hearts reach out to Peter's cherished wife, Helen, of 26 years. Peter was a much loved father, father-in-law, and stepfather to Ross and Amy, Paul and Leanne, Troy and Belinda, Jay, and Michael, who's no longer with us. Peter was an adored poppy to Grace, Jeffrey, Ali, Xavier, Lexi, Claudia, and Bailey. A loving brother and brother-in-law to Jeffrey and Michael, both deceased, Alan and Liz, and Gail, and a wonderful uncle to his nieces and nephews, as well as a beloved son-in-law to Mary. We also take time to think about everyone here today. Peter's gentle and nurturing nature will definitely be remembered by you all. To the side, you can see that there are six lit candles, and the candles help us remember those that we have lost, and the flame is considered a source of guiding light in a time of darkness. The first candle represents grief. The pain of losing Peter is intense and reminds us of the depth of your love for him. The second candle represents the courage to confront your sorrows and to comfort each other. The third candle is in Peter's memory. The times of laughter and the times of tears, and the caring and joy that he gave to you all. The fourth candle is for your love for Peter and for the special place in your hearts that will always be reserved for him. The fifth candle is for gratitude and for enriching the lives of those he loved. We thank Peter for his unwavering support and unconditional love. And the sixth candle is lit for hope. Hope that Peter's memory will never be erased from you, your memories. And may the glow of this flame be your source of hopefulness, now and forevermore. I'd like to now share our first reading, chosen by Helen, and it's titled The Last Journey. There is a train at the station with a seat reserved just for me. I'm excited about its destination, as I've heard it sets you free. The trials and tribulations, the pain and stress we breathe, don't exist where I am going, only happiness, I believe. I hope that you'll be there to wish me on my way. It's not a journey you can join in. It's not your time today. There'll be many destinations. Some are happy and some are sad. Each one a brief reminder of the great times that we've had. Many friends I know are waiting, who took an earlier train to greet and reassure me that nothing has really changed. We'll take the time together to catch up on the past, to build a new beginning, one that will always last. One day you'll take your journey on the train just like me, and I promise that I'll be there at the station, and you'll see that life is just a journey enriched by those you meet. No one can take that from you. It's always yours to keep. But now, as no seat is vacant, you will have to muddle through. Make sure you fulfil your ambitions, as you know I'll be watching you. And if there is an occasion to mention who you knew, speak kindly of that person, as one day it will be you. Remember not my fight for breath, remember not my strife. Please do not dwell upon my death, but celebrate my life. I will miss you all dearly, so keep up your chin until the day comes we're together again. Beautiful poem. Thank you for allowing me to share that. Peter was 6'1", tall man, and despite his towering physique, he possessed a quiet demeanour that spoke volumes. Peter, with his gentle and placid nature, possessed a calmness that radiated from within and brought a sense of peace to those around him. Peter always remained composed, his words measured, and his actions deliberate. And he never felt the need to speak unless he had something significant to say. Peter, affectionately known as Bondi, which came about when he was working with the Bond brothers many years ago, and the common link of the red hair, and there's something good about the red hair, let me say, and this name has actually stayed with him throughout his life. So Bondi and Helen met through a blind double date that Helen's friend Linny had arranged. Linny's partner at the time knew Bondi, and together they began their matchmaking. The date was at the Baruga Golf Club, and a fun night was had by all. I asked Helen what her initial thoughts of Bondi were, to which she replied, "Nice looking, but bloody tall." At the end of the night, Helen gave Bondi her phone number, but it was a few weeks later when he finally asked her out, and the next date was in Tokemoor. Although they eventually got engaged, Helen wasn't too fussed about marrying, given that they had both been previously married. But Bondi said, "I want to do this right." And Helen finally agreed. And 26 years ago, on the 29th of June, 1997, they embarked on a journey of love, commitment, and vowing to stand by each other's side through thick and thin, which has always been the case, as they have supported each other with unwavering affection and loyalty. Unfortunately, moving forward, this anniversary milestone will carry bittersweet memories, especially for Helen. For it was on this same day that Peter, Helen's beloved partner, departed from this world. As a blended family unit, and also as a couple, Bondi and Helen love camping by the Murray River. They owned a fishing boat and even taught their children to ski on it. Travelling became a passion for Bondi and Helen once retired. They bought a caravan completely equipped and would explore the wonderful sights of Australia. In 2019, they made the trek from Strathmerton to Tom Price, which is around 4,000 kilometres, to visit Peter's son Ross and his family. They travelled with their Staffy Cross companion, Sox, who may have actually been the most spoilt dog ever known, to the point I was told that she was wrapped in a dressing gown to keep her warm throughout the trip. The last caravan trip they made was to visit Peter's other son, Paul, and his family in Gippsland. Family held an extraordinary significance in Peter's life and in his heart. His grandchildren held a special place of love and joy. Being with them brought a renewed sense of purpose and fulfillment to his life. And I hear his grandchildren could wrap him around their little fingers, especially when they wanted something from Poppy. Bondi and Helen shared another love, crossword puzzles. Each week, they would purchase the Take 5 and the That's Life magazines and would each work through each one, reaching out to each other if they became stuck on a clue. After a few days, they would then swap magazines and attempt to complete the gaps. It was never a competition though, but embracing a supportive and collaborative approach. 3 years ago, Peter received a life-altering diagnosis, dementia. And this news shook the foundation of his world and that of his loved ones. Despite the hardships, Peter's spirit remained resilient, and even as dementia slowly stole fragments of his memory, his essence continued to shine through in moments of clarity and connection. As his dementia advanced, Helen's mum Mary bought Peter a stuffed dog, a collie named Lassie, which became a source of comfort and familiarisation and a constant presence by Peter's side. So it only seems fitting that Lassie is now laid to rest with Peter. I have also Peter's niece, Bernadette, and she has something she would like to share from her dad. Thank you.
I'm Bernadette, Peter's niece. My dad, Peter's brother, can't be here today because of illness. But he's written me some words for Peter that he's asked me to share with you today. Peter was dearly loved. He was 4 years older than me, and I remember him as self-sufficient from a young age, off on his own adventures, making his own way. But throughout the years, he was a good brother to me. We shared a love of the country and the quiet life, stemming from our childhood growing up in Grantville. As an adult, it was always a pleasure catching up with Peter and sharing a beer. He was a relaxing and easy person to be around. His down-to-earth nature meant he easily got along with whoever he met. Peter will always reside in my memory and my heart. He was a beloved member of our family, and I'm devastated Peter didn't have more time to enjoy his plans with Eileen and their retirement. He will be forever loved. I am deeply appreciative of how Eileen took care of him in his last few years. May he rest in peace.
Thanks, Bernadette. I would like to now share our second reading, titled One at Rest. Think of me as one at rest. For me, you should not weep. I have no pain, no troubled thoughts, for I am just asleep. The living thinking me that was is now forever still. And life goes on without me now, as time forever will. If your heart is heavy now because I've gone away, dwell not long upon it, friend, for none of us can stay. For those of you who liked me, I sincerely thank you all. And those of you who loved me, I thank you most of all. And in my fleeting lifespan, as time went rushing by, I found some time to hesitate, to laugh, to love, to cry. Matters it now if time began, if time will ever cease? I was here, I used it all, and now I am at peace. When we experience the pain of losing someone dear, we're confronted with the fleeting nature of life and the importance of embracing every moment with love and intention. It is through love that we form bonds, create memories, and leave a lasting impression on those that are around us. And today, I can see there is so much love here for Peter. So Peter, with the love that surrounds you, rest now. At the end of your days, your work is done. And here now, we tenderly, lovingly, and reverently commit the spirit and body of Peter to a more peaceful place. We have been remembering with love and gratitude a life that has ended. Peter, we give thanks for your love, life, friendship, and your memories. Thank you, Bondi. Thank you for the good times. Thank you for your hard work. Thank you for your love and laughter. Thank you for being you. You leave this world a richer place than you found it. Continue your journey, Peter, with the love of everyone here. Be reunited with family and friends gone before you. You will live on in the hearts of everyone you touched and nurtured whilst you lived on this earth. And with great respect, we bid you a final farewell. As we conclude this service, I'd like to thank you all for your love, support and attendance today, and invite you to join the family for refreshments at the Strathmerton Bowling Club, where you can continue to share your happy memories of Bondi. A special thank you to the staff at Irvine House who have lovingly cared for Peter since March this year. In a short moment, the final songs chosen by the family, It's 5 O'Clock Somewhere by Alan Jackson And My Heart Will Go On by Celine Dion will play as Peter's family will take him to the hearse. And this reminds us that whilst Peter's song may have ended, his melody will continue to linger on. Thank you. Can I please ask you all to stand and honour Peter as the music starts?
Do we have Paul there to help us? Thank you.
Getting paid by the hour, an old environment. My boss just pushed me over the limit. I'd like to call or something. I think I'm just calling a day. Vacation.